Eliminated from the British Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, but I thought rather fortunately outpointed John McDermott in his last outing. And Scott Gamma, Mickey Steeds. Both have 7 stoppages on their record, but Scott Gamma's fought 10 less contests. And Scott Gamma, the one with the repeated punch, Scott the Hammer Gamma. With Mark Krentz, former ABA cruiserweight champion, really shot to prominence by taking Audley Harris in the distance. Mark Krentz usually works well with his left lead. Imagine Gamma for inclined to hook. Gamma falling short with that left lead. Body punch there from Scott Gamma. Referee for this one, the sub-heavyweight in the ring, star class referee Terry O'Connor. Some strength was stopped by Konstantin Krizuk in the 6th round. And his other loss on his record. And I'm trying to throw some body punches. Over 10 rounds, that might be a good tactic to slow his man down. Then falling short with that left lead. In the corner with him and promoter manager Paul Boyce. And that's Richard Foxen and Dennis Hobson. That's Mark Krentz. Krentz can't afford to fall short with that last lead. And too often it has, so far. He's to try and stop Scott Gamma setting up his attack. Gamma getting through a couple of rights. have got through, but the first one missed. Gama looking just to get inside and what was hit. Back. Some encouragement from the home crowd. So they say just too often those lead punches just not landing. Foxen smoothing out a few of the bumps. Scott Gammer has wins over two of our local heavyweights. Sheffield's Paul King is stopped in two rounds. Well, I thought the stoppage was a bit premature, and he outpointed the 20 stone plus Al Baker. Both Paul King and Carl Baker are in the audience here this afternoon at Sheffield. That is a good jab there from Mark Trent. Needs more of that, needs to double up his jab. His opponent getting in close, landing those hooks. Working more to the body, try and bring Matt Prince's hands down. Scott Gammer mustn't fall into a trap of just looking for big punches. Got to pick up some points along the way as well. But Trent there. Trent just retreating. Back on his jab. shot comes there from Welshman. Kadama looks to be landing the more telling punches. Prince has got to compensate by throwing the greater volume of punches. Kadama having a good last 30 seconds. Up in this round. Trying to fight back now. Been a good round of boxing. Exciting action, particularly as Scott Gammer unloaded. Prince has survived and to say scoring himself near the end of the round. That's him, Prince. Off kick there. Kadama goes back to his corner. Kent fought back well in that fourth round after threatening to be overwhelmed by the attacks of Scott Gammer. So round five. Prince's chin has stood up so far to the Hammer's attacks. Left lead. Slow start from Scott Gammer in this fifth round. From Scott Gammer. Right there from Scott Gammer. Right through the guard of Mark Trent. Less frenetic than the previous round. Second half of this round, this heavyweight title eliminator. Heavyweight champion, of course, Matt Skelton. Duke of Ox, Danny Williams, allegedly. Oh, dominating with that left leg. Tries a right. Partly blocked there by Mark Brent. Again looking to land, nice left hook button on the chin, and again the left getting through. Solid shots coming from Scott Gamma. Starting to put his punches together. Combination. Bends his head back. Trent seems quite composed. Difficult to see that Welsh corner, I see, with the angle of match. Neither man hit the deck yet. Partially blocked there by Mark Trent. Scott Gamma, 15 stone 3, not a big heavyweight by modern day standards. Scott Gamma. Trent poking out that left lead. Scotty O'Connor in a good position there. Able to discern what's landing and what isn't. Scott Dummer looking to land the more telling shot. Trying to go forward. Down the cover back. From Mark Trent got through. Looking to get through with that left leg. That's encouraging the supporters. Back comes Scott Dammer. Oh! Jump stagger there. Scott Dammer looking to finish.